So I'm here today with Ed Knight, and we're here to look at bus safety. Welcome to Latest TV News, Ed. First of all, what's your role and why are you here today?
Thank you very much for that. Yes, my role within the company for Brighton and Hove Buses and also for Metro Bus in Crawley, I'm the insurance and claims manager. And we're actually here today to demonstrate for safety purposes where the blind spot is in the mirror with cyclists. How we're actually doing it is we're asking cyclists to come along, sit in the bus, and then we show them what the view is like for the driver, which a lot of cyclists are actually very surprised what the view is, because they are big, they are long vehicles. Yeah. So they really get a hands-on effect of this is what it's like by exchanging places.
Yeah.
Okay, right, well, you're sat in the driver's seat of the bus now, and what you've got to think of is what the bus driver can see. The bus driver is busy looking in the near side mirror. He's also looking in this interior mirror, which is showing the passengers downstairs. Also, just in front of him, he's got a camera that's showing him what's happening upstairs on the bus. Then he's also got the offside mirror, which is showing him obviously what's happening on that offside of the bus. And in between looking at these four, he's also got to be able to look where he's going and what he's doing, whether he's going to be accelerating, braking, etc. Now, if I go round to the other side of the bus on the offside, I can explain where the large spot is, the blind spot on the mirror. So I'll just go round the other side for you. Okay, so I'm on the offside of the bus now. Now, what you've got to think of is the bus driver is looking in these four mirrors, three mirrors and a camera, shall I say, right? So he can't look only in this offside mirror all the time. He's also got to look where he's going and what he's doing with the various bus controls, right? So what I'd like you to do now is look in this offside mirror, right? And you can see the bus behind you, right? But if, for an example, you're a cyclist and I stand here and I'm on my cycle, can you see me in that offside mirror? And then I come up and I'm level with the bus, can you see me in the mirror? Right? And I have to go all the way back, and presumably you still can't see me in the mirror. So what I'm going to do now is, while you're looking through the offside mirror, I'm going to ask a cyclist to come down the offside of the bus, and then you will see where the blind spot is. So if the driver is busy looking where he's going and looking in the other mirrors and the camera, a cyclist can creep up on the bus driver. So I'll get the cyclist to run down the offside of the bus. So here comes the cyclist now. If you look in that mirror, and you'll be able to see, when do they disappear? They're not there. So if you as a bus driver are busy looking where you're going, looking in the mirror, watching your passengers, looking at the passengers for the safety and comfort of them, a cyclist can arrive on the offside of the bus and he's in the blind spot. And that's the danger zone. So we want to emphasise to cyclists where the blind spots are on a bus, and that's what we're doing today.
Cycling is fantastic for you. Its health benefits, both physical, mental, and indeed your pockets, are great. But there is a risk there. It's outweighed about 20 times to one to the small risk that there is in the roads. And obviously I want to minimise this. Yeah. It's awareness both of drivers, of cyclists, and of pedestrians as well. Yeah. Pedestrian walkouts, that kind of thing, is a problem. And of course, cyclists doing the wrong thing, like going through red lights, etc., put the passengers on buses at risk if a bus driver's got to emergency stop, all those kind of things. So we want to minimise the risk.
Because there's an increasing amount of bikes in Brighton, we've got a good cycle lane provision. So the risk has been higher, is it because there's more cyclists on the streets in Brighton?
Well, I think it's just a question of we work very closely and in harmony with cyclists. We do a lot of work with Sussex University. We've held a similar event twice at Sussex University where we work with the cyclists there, because there's a lot of cyclists that go to university. We've held these events before within Brighton, and by working closely together, you eliminate the possibility, really, of any incidents.
I mean, how can people find out more information? How can they be more aware? Apart from attending today's event, what else can people do, or what can the council do to make people more aware?
Well, we've got a Facebook page, Share the Roads Brighton and Hove, and there are videos on there, and if you look online, the Met Police in London have got an excellent Exchanging Places VR film which enables you to get the complete feeling of what it's like to be the driver and to be the cyclist.
Yeah.
So you can do that quite easily, and we've got much more information online as well.